Secure PLC Messaging is now available in the latest version of the Productivity Programming Suite. To be able to use this feature, you must have installed Productivity Programming Suite version 3.4 or higher, and then load the latest firmware to the Productivity CPU. There are three parts to this setup. First is the DNS. If your email server is using a naming convention like this and not a direct IP, you'll need to set up DNS. This server is used to resolve the IP address of the name being used. To set it up, go into your hardware configuration and select the CPU. Select the Ethernet port tab, and here enter in the DNS server. I would advise using your ISP provider's DNS, but if you're unsure of what that address is, you could always use Google's public DNS server. Now that you have that set up, select OK, and then select here on the Mail Accounts tab. You can have up to 4 email accounts set up into your PLC project. If you look here, you'll notice that there's account templates for some of the more common email servers. If you don't see your email provider here, select Custom, and then you'll enter in the information provided by your email provider. Now I'm setting up Gmail, so I'm going to select here. So give your account a name. This will be the name using the email instruction later. This template has already set up my service name, so if you're doing a custom setup, you'll have to enter this in manually. The encryption port and port number you see is already set up also. I really like these templates. It makes this setup so much simpler. Now, this certificate portion is used to verify the identity of the email server. When we create this account here in our project, this certificate becomes part of our PLC project. When an email instruction is triggered, the mail server certificates are validated as part of establishing the encrypted connection. Most cases using the default certificate will work for your application, especially for the templates provided here. Some organizational email accounts will require that you use a custom certificate or no verification option. Enter in your username and password, hit OK, and that completes the email client setup. Now let's create a test email. I'm going to create a triggering bit for my email. Enter in the email instruction. A point here before we get started. These fields here, you can place a tag or enter in direct text. If you do enter in direct text, it must be inside quotation marks. If it is not inside of quotation marks, the software will believe it's a tag. Now I'm going to select to use a structure. When I do this, these fields will get tags created for them that will be part of the structure like this. Now select the email client we created before. Here I will enter in the from address as direct text, making sure to include the quotation marks. I'm going to select to add the error and event file and also the log file. And these files will be the most current files on the CPU. For the destination address, I'm going to enter in a tag. Now that you have that entered, select OK. I would advise changing all your strings to at least 64 characters. Now for these, I would go ahead and go with the max number of characters. And I would also advise to make sure that these are retentive. Now, one of the things I want you to make note of, both the message and subject are strings, and the max characters for these are 128. You'll need to keep this in mind when creating your email messages. Select OK. And let's send this to our CPU. Now that I've created the message, I'm going to select the line the instruction is on, right-click on it, and then add it to my data view. I'll give the tab a name. Now this is a feature I really love in Productivity. It really makes it easy to troubleshoot your code. All the tags that are associated on this rung are then added to this one data view tab. Now let's go into our data view and select that tab. I'm going to manually enter in the text for my subject, message, and destination address. To create your string and ladder code, you will use a pack string instruction. Now that I have this information entered, I'm going to send that to the PLC. And now enable the instruction. Now you're going to see that your instruction is in progress. Ma'am, we have a success. If you do have an error, this tag will instruct you of the error's cause. If you have any questions or comments on any of these features, please feel free to comment below or call into our technical support team. Select here to see more videos in the Productivity platform and make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel for upcoming products and solutions.